I'm going to show you how to use QDA Miner Lite to code your data. Coding is all about going through your transcript, identifying information that you think is significant based on the research question that you have, and then develop phrase or a group of phrases to represent the significant information. But before you do the coding process, it's very important for you to think about your research question. Let me show you something quickly before we go use the software. Here we have two research questions. The first research question is, what are the causes of burnout among primary healthcare physicians? And the second one is about the solutions, right? So you see here that you have to first label your research question. We have the first research question, we label it as burnout causes. The second one is burnout solution. Why should you label your research question? Because you're going to develop codes and bring them under their respective research question. It will help the analysis part and also developing of the themes to help you to address your research question. So it's always good to do the coding and put them under their respective research question. It's very good practice. It makes your work very easy in terms of doing your analysis. So now that you have labeled your research question, we go to the free qualitative software that you can use to analyze your data. So we're going to start with participant one. So you can see the transcript here. Here is the place that you're going to do the coding. You're going to generate codes. You first have to go to your transcript. So when you go through, let's see whether we can find something that is related to research question one or two. So long hours is significant information addressing the research question one. Research question one is about the causes of burnout. What do you have to do? One thing that you could do here is to right click here, right? And then click on add code. You'll be able to give the label to the significant information you are planning to select. So we are planning to select long hours. So the code could be having long hours. And because we are using participant words, we can put a quotation marks there to just remind you that we're using the participant word to do the coding. Sometimes their words are very powerful to use for the coding. Sometimes you can create your own phrase to represent the significant information. This time we are using participant own words because it best reflects the information that we are selecting, addressing the first research question. So you see here under category, this is where you put your label for the research question one there, because you are going to put the code under the research question one. So what do you have to do here? You type the code for the research question one. I think we have it here. So I'm going to just copy and paste. I copy this one and paste it here. And then in parentheses, you can put RQ1 and close it. Here, you can give a description. This is where you give information about what the code represents. If the code is so obvious, you remember what it represents. You don't have to put any information here. But if you want to provide what it represents, you can text type, this code represents participant expression of the long hours they spend working with patient or providing service to patient. So you can say this code represents participants' expression of the long hours they spend taking care of patients. When you finish, you can click on add, right? So you see here that when I click on add, the information comes here, right? So we have the research question and the label representing the significant information. Think about the label as like a container, where now you're going to drop the significant information into the container. So how do you do that? You can just select the significant information and click here. You double click. When you double click, so you see how the code is here. So you can see here that the code is connected to the significant information. Another way of doing it is you can go to code here and click on add, and then that information will be here. So let's try the second way of doing the coding. I think this information is significant. I'm looking for lack of balance with work and home life. So we select that, and then we go to code, we click on add, and then we decide on a label. So the good label here is no work family balance. So the label should be in between 2 to 5 words representing the significant information at the same time addressing the research question that you have. So we bring the code here and it's under this research question, right? So then you click on add. Then what you have to do is you close this window and then you double click because you have already selected a significant, double click here. And you can see that that information has been brought here, right? So there's another third option that you could do, right? And I'm going to show you the third option. So let's go through again. There's a solution here, engaging in meditation. When you look at the participant response to the interview question 9, engaging in meditation. So engaging in prayer, we label it as engaging in meditation or spending time in prayer. So we select that significant information. You look at this place, you see the plus sign, and then you click on that plus sign, and then you bring the label here. And this time it's addressing the second research question. So you have to click on this. You take this information there because you're going to type the second research question, which is burnout solutions. And then in parentheses, RQ2. And then you click on OK. This one is easy because you see the process. You selected the significant information. You go to this plus sign here and you click on that. And then you can type the code. And when you click on OK, the information will be tagged to this one. It's very different from first option where you first have to create the code and then you select and then double click on it and that information is here. So there are many ways of doing the coding. You just have to choose the one that you feel comfortable. Let me go to the first option. You select and then you create. You right click here, you add here, and then you provide a code. You select a category, which is the research question that is connected to the code, and then you click on add. And then after that, you just have to double click and the code will be tagged to that significant information. The second option is just selecting the significant information and clicking on the plus sign, right? And then you'll be able to type the code and put it under their respective research question. And then you click on OK, and that code will be connected to the significant information. So that's how the coding process is, right? Should we try another one? Reflection and engaging and spending time in prayer and reflection is part of meditation, right? And you can see here that I only selected this one. So that's a mistake that you might make. So let's say you made a mistake and coded this one. You can just right click here and remove coding. Right, when you remove, it's not tagged to this one anymore, but the information is still here, right? The code is still here, but it's not tagged to any significant information. If you want to select appropriate section, then you do the selection and then double click on this one and then the information will come here. Let's try the exercising. So the person engaged in exercise is part of the solution. So you select it and go here and you can type engaging in exercising. And this one is for the second research question, which is the burnout solution. So you click on that and click on OK. So you see how that information is here. So let's go to participant 2. There is information here. This one is more of having numerous work related. You see here that we have already created a container that is called having numerous work related. You see here that we made a mistake. We didn't bring the task. You can make a correction by right-clicking here and going to edit code. And you can add the task there and click on OK. Now that we have selected this information and we already have the container, right? So the coding is all about when you identify significant information, you always have to look into the already developed code and see whether you can connect the significant information to one of the codes that you have. If not, then you can create a new code. You select and double click and you have this code here. Let's try another one. This one, we can drop it in this container again. And then taking care of multiple patients is another code. This one is significant, but there's no code that we can drop this one into. So we have to create a new one under the research question one. So the new one will be taking care of multiple patients. You click here and then you type the code. It's participant onwards, so we can just quote the place. Just to remind you that that information, that phrase is from participant. Then you select research question one because it's about the causes of burnout. And then you click on OK. So that's how you're going to do. You see how it's easy. You first select the transcript and go through and identify information that you think is significant. You select and then click on the plus sign. And if there's no existing code that can be used to connect to this significant information, you create a new code, right? So in this case, we can create a new code if you think the one that you have here are not addressing the research question that you have. So that's how you're going to do it. So let me show you the final product. So this is how, you know, the final product is going to be like. After the coding, I've coded all the transcripts, and these are the codes that I developed. And then you can look at this place. You can see all the codes that are connected to the significant information in the participant 5 transcript. And then if you want to know the areas that were coded, you can go to document and go to coded test and click on highlight. It will highlight places that have been coded. So that's how the coding process is. So as I said, coding is all about creating containers and dropping the significant information to them. The code is just a phrase in between 2 to 5 words representing the significant information that you have selected from the data, at the same time helping you to address your research question that you have. So this is how we're going to use the QDA Miner Lite to do the coding. The next step is to categorize your code. The reason why you have to engage in categorization is that you cannot just present all these as themes because they are a lot. So what you have to think about is, can you look at the relationship between the codes and then try to categorize them into clusters or into categories or themes, and then use the themes to address the research question that you have. So the next video is to show you how to create themes and then use the themes to address the research question. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video.